For 60 years, the Science for Peace and Security program has been promoting worldwide security-related practical cooperation to address emerging security challenges. In celebration of its 60th anniversary, we invite you to look back at the rich history of the program and consider its accomplishments. Cooperation among NATO nations in the field of science and technology is rooted in Article 2 of the Washington Treaty. The SPS program can be traced back to 1957, when the foreign ministers of Canada, Italy, and Norway, known as the Three Wise Men, recommended cooperation among nations in the non-military field to foster ties amongst civilian communities of the alliance. It led to the creation in 1958 of the NATO Science Committee. This new initiative was triggered by the launch of Sputnik, a satellite which demonstrated clearly the gap between the Soviet and Allied missile technology.
But nobody seemed aware of the Soviet Union's vast and secret crash rocket program until October 1957, when Sputnik 1 appeared, man's first satellite to orbit.
This marked the beginning of long-term networks among scientists and researchers through NATO science fellowships, promoting research and development in Allied countries. Throughout the Cold War, the program delivered substantial achievements through modest investments, overcoming the security divide among allies. Going beyond hard science in 1969, the program extended to environmental security with the creation of the Committee on the Challenges of Modern Society.
In establishing CCMS, NATO was recognizing its treaty obligation to promote conditions of stability and well-being.
With the end of the Cold War and the collapse of the Soviet Union, NATO reached out to countries of Central and Eastern Europe. In 1991, the North Atlantic Cooperation Council was created, which later became the Euro-Atlantic Partnership Council. The science program shifted its geographical scope from an intra-alliance to an alliance partner focus. With the signing of the Founding Act between NATO and the Russian Federation in 1997, the science program developed activities with Russian scientists in the field of counter-terrorism, CBRN, and transport security. Many research projects address the Cold War legacy, notably in Azerbaijan and Uzbekistan with Melange, that is, the conversion of abandoned liquid ballistic missile propellants, and in the Republic of Moldova with the establishment of an analytical laboratory for analysis of pesticides. Reflecting the political and technological developments of the 90s, the science program focused primarily on activities related to environmental security and computer networking. Let's remember, for instance, the virtual Silk Highway, working with countries of Central Asia and the Caucasus. In 2006, the Science for Peace and Security program was launched by merging the science and CCMS committees to support practical cooperation with partner countries in civil science and innovation. In 2011, the SPS program reflected NATO's political agenda with a set of new key priorities linked to emerging security challenges and providing support to NATO-led operations and missions, improving early warning and forecasts of disasters as well as crises, and supporting NATO's agenda on women, peace, and security. Today, the SPS program provides well-established and globally recognized mechanisms based on scientific research and technological innovation. Independent scientists evaluate applications and recommend them based on their merits for approval by allies. SPS activities revolve around flagship multi-year projects towards supporting capacity building of emergency response and management in the Western Balkan region, providing partner countries with national crisis emergency coordination centers, assisting the monitoring of chemical munition dump sites in the Baltic Sea by the means of autonomous underwater vehicles, providing early warning and forecasts of disasters and crises through advanced technologies, allowing first responders quick and swift accessing of medical expertise through a transnational telemedicine system, and providing affordable high-speed internet access via satellites for academic communities in the Caucasus and Central Asia, including Afghanistan. Advanced training courses towards strengthening the capabilities of allies and partner nations in the fight against terrorism and dealing with cyber attacks and CBRN incidents. SPS advanced research workshops towards sharing knowledge and best practices on common challenges such as smart energy. Tailored advanced study institutes towards bringing together young scientists, updating them on the latest advances in security-related civil science areas. Looking back on the past 60 years, the SPS program has gone through important changes, streamlining for greater efficiency and oversight, and adapting to new circumstances and global threats. Currently, over 120 activities involving all NATO allies cooperating with over 30 partner countries are ongoing, reflecting a 360-degree approach with partners from the South, East, and global partners. Engaging young scientists is a strong focus of SPS multi-year projects.
Today, it is about strengthening security through joint practical cooperation between allies and partners, mirroring NATO's political agenda and focusing on key priority areas, with projects, for instance, in cyber defense, counter-terrorism, hybrid warfare, resilience, and capacity building with our partners.